National Assembly Day. Of Chief of Staff are about agreeing right now. At the moment, the House Committee is set to screen the service chief, and GTV is online. Our promise. Let's come live for one event that are too critical are going on. The chairman of the House of Representatives intends to ensure that the government is the one talking to us now. Like our Facebook page, subscribe to our YouTube channel, GTV. Promise that everything will be live to you from the National Assembly. I am the anchor of this program. By the National Assembly, it
reiterates the supremacy of civil authority over the military in a constitutional democracy. We shall therefore take our role very seriously, and we intend to discharge our responsibility diligently on behalf of Nigeria. Nigeria as a country is blessed with brave and gallant soldiers, many of whom have paid the supreme price for service to the country. It is to their memory that we must gain the prize with our national security and help secure the peace for which they lost their lives. We are therefore here today perform the screening exercise of the nominees as part of the legal confirmation process. From the inception of this night, House of Representatives, national security has been discussed more than 200 times at plenary. Yet the nation is still grappling with diverse and increasing security challenges, despite some successes recorded by the men and women of our armed forces. While I appreciate that there is no single magic solution, I believe the kind of leadership provided to our armed forces is part of the solution list. I can assure you, Nigerians, that the nominees will be grilled on questions covering a wide range of subjects. Areas in which they will be questioned include professional skill and expertise and experience,
service chiefs and the CDS to assure you that we will promise to deliver the necessary expectations from members of the country and the House of Assembly. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister of Defense, for that wonderful remark. We are getting to the nitty-gritty of today's assignment. I would like to hand over to the chairman of the ad hoc committee, Honorable Babajimi Benson, to kindly invite the nominees to give their initial remarks. Honorable Babajimi Benson, please.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Honorable Minister. The CDS kindly, the nominee CDS, this CDS designate, kindly let us know, let Nigerians know the vision you have. Kindly run us through your CV to let Nigerians know who you are and what you have to offer. Yes, please come to the podium.
Chairman of the screening committee, who is also the chairman of the House Committee on Defense. The chairman of the House Committee on the Army, as well as that of Navy and the Air Force. Honorable members of this very distinguished committee, the Honorable Minister of Defense, my colleagues, the nominated service chiefs, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Let me first and foremost, before running through my curriculum vitae, appreciate the members of this committee and by extension the larger National Assembly for the honor to appear before you. I am Major General Lucky Eluonye Onyenuchia Irabor. I hail from Aliokpo in Eka South local government of Delta State. Without giving details of all the schools that I attended, suffice to say that I attended a Eka Grammar School, Agbo. Thereafter, proceeded to the Nigerian Defense Academy as an officer cadet, and thereafter was commissioned in 1986. From there, I proceeded to the Obafemi Awolowo University, where I studied electrical electronics engineering. I've had extensive courses covering both military and other spheres as it pertains to my career as an officer of the Armed Forces of the Federal Republic. In the course of my career, I've equally held appointments both on the command, instructional, as well as staff, many of which perhaps in due course will be given in my CV. But suffice to mention that on the command, I was one time the commanding officer of 515 Signal Regiment. I was equally the commander of 53 Signal Brigade. I was also the theater command Operation Lafia Adole, as well as the first commander Multinational Joint Task Force. Until my recent nomination and appointment by Mr. President, I was the commander of Training and Doctrine Command, Nigerian Army. May I also say that as on the staff, I was one time the Chief of Defense Training and Operations, and I've also had different appointments both at the services as well as the defense headquarters. If you permit, Mr. Chairman, distinguished members of this committee, I'd like to also indicate that I've had extensive experiences with respect to operations, both in Nigeria as well as under the auspices of the ECOMOG and the United Nations. Within the country, as mentioned, as part of my tour of duty as a commander, the operations in the Northeast currently ongoing, wherein we're dealing with issues of terrorism and insurgency. I served, and my colleagues, almost all my colleagues that I also nominated, were part and parcel of that experience. And I believe that as we interact further, perhaps the details of our engagement will be made known. Also, whilst serving in ECOMOG, I operated both in Liberia and Sierra Leone, and thereafter, I was part of the contingent of the United Nations also that later on stabilized Liberia as well as Sierra Leone. Just distinguished chairman and members of this committee, I'd like to indicate that if I have confirmed.
Yes, you're on live to GTV Africa, live from National Assembly. The screening of the service chief is ongoing, and I am Beniga Olamikon, the crew of GTV, live from National Assembly here. With the crew of GTV Africa live from National Assembly. Chief of Defense Staff designate is the one talking to members.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you very
much. Well, the nominee has just spoken to the members. And it's back to the seat. While we await the remaining people to talk, well, the Major General is stepping further to talk, to address.
Chairman, our distinguished honorable chairman, House committee.
to GTV Africa live from National Assembly. The screening of service chiefs is ongoing.
Let me start with the vision. is repositioned to professionally defeat all adversaries in a joint environment. Emphasis will be particularly on whole of government approach and whole of society approach, where each and every Nigerian will be part of the security architecture to bring an end to our current problems. The vision is undergirded within the command philosophy on specific pillars: readiness, duty to country, dependability, and continuous leadership development. For particular emphasis, readiness will entail mission readiness, training, functional manning and equipment. Duty to country, we'll talk about loyalty and sacrifice to the fatherland. Dependability will be on the Nigerian Army's capacity and capability to accomplish mission. And continuous leadership development will be an army that will be innovative. We have innovative leadership into the 21st century. Having said that, I think with these few remarks, the committee has a better view of who the Chief of Army Staff Designate is. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Chief of Army Staff Designate. You may please take your seats. I'd now like to invite the Chief of Naval Staff Designate to please come to the podium and address us.
Chairman, House Committee on Defense, and Chairman of this screening committee, Honorable Baba Jimmy Benson, Chairman, House Committee on Army, Chairman, House Committee on Navy, and Chairman, House Committee on Air Force, other distinguished members of this screening committee, Honorable Minister of Defense, the Presidential Liaison Officer to the National Assembly, Umar Eliyahu, the Chief of Defense Staff, and other service chiefs, senior military officers, distinguished invited guests, members of the 4th Estate of the Ring, gentlemen, I am Rear Admiral Awwal, Zubairu, Gambo, and I hail from Nasarawa Local Government of Kano State, born 22nd April 1966. I attended, among other institutions, Rufa College, where I graduated with the school certificate. I was a member of the 36th Regular Bus NDA. And I start by acknowledging the Almighty God for his benevolence that resulted in my being favored with appointment as the 21st Indigenous Chief of the Naval Staff. I express appreciation to President Muhammadu Buhari, who, finding me worthy, among many other equally qualified and competent colleagues, to be appointed. The appointment is particularly significant coming at a critical time that our nation is facing many security challenges, and I am honored to be part of the team that has been assembled to address these challenges. Distinguished members of this committee, A broad look at my resume shows a career path spanning over 3 decades, during which I received quality military and professional training at home and abroad, and served in diverse capacities ashore and afloat in the Nigerian Navy. I also made modest efforts at self-development as evidenced by my academic qualifications that I acquired as well as my membership of some professional bodies. On the whole, I am here before this honorable and distinguished committee, an operations naval officer with a background in intelligence, a military diplomat, and an administrator. However, I am not under any illusion that all these aforementioned attainments can solely, by themselves, earn me success as the chief of the naval staff, if confirmed. I need a great deal of the loyalty, cooperation, commitment, knowledge, and skills of all officers, ratings, and civilian staff of the Nigerian Navy, and my goal is to optimally harness this for the benefit of the service and the nation. Distinguished committee, sir, if confirmed as the chief of the naval staff, I intend, as my vision, to leverage on all factors of national location, technology, training, teamwork, and synergy to re-energize the Nigerian Navy and enhance her as a well-motivated and ready naval force in the discharge of her constitutional mandate and other tasks in fulfillment of national security objectives. I thank you for this opportunity and look forward to the closed session where more details will be revealed. Thank you.
Chairman Screening Committee, also the Chairman House Committee on Defense, Chairman House Committee on Air Force, Chairman House Committee on Army, and Chairman House Committee on Navy. Other honorable members of the Screening Committee, the Honorable Minister of Defense, the Chief of Defense Staff Designate, and my colleagues, the service chief designate, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, members of the press. I am Air Vice Marshal Isiaka Oladayo, Amao, born on the 14th September 1965 at Enugu State. I am from Oshogbo local government, Oshogbo, Osun State. I attended my primary school at Bamali Primary School, Kaduna, as well as Command Secondary School, Kaduna, Kasi and Metro, Nigeria. Okay, I listened to the Nigerian Air Force on the 19th January 1984 as a member of the 35th Regular Course and was commissioned pilot officer on 20th December 1986. From then, I progressed steadily through the ranks until I was promoted Air Vice Marshal on 19th January 2015. which include the junior, the primary flying training, primary and secondary flying training courses in Kaduna and Kano. I'm a fighter pilot and also an instructor pilot. I also have a master's degree in defense and strategic studies from University of India. That's University of Madras, India, as well as Master of Military Science and Strategy from the University of China. I've had several opponents that have given me weight of experience in the Nigerian Air Force. I have good operational and administrative experience. Among the command appointments I've had include the Commander 407 Air Combat Training Group training. I was the Commander 103 Strike Group Yula. I was also the Air Component Commander, Operation Zama Latvia and Operation Latvia Village. I was also a Deputy Theater Commander, Operation Latvia Village. The period I was the commander in the operation was when our territories were in the hands of the Boko Haram, and we fought currently to collect back those territories. That was in 2015. I was also the Air Officer Commanding Tactical Air Command in the Nigerian Air Force, and before my appointment as the Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, I was the Commandant Armed Forces Resettlement Center at Ushu. I've had several staff appointments. I was the Deputy Defense Advisor to Nigerian High Commissioner in London. And I also became the Acting Defense Advisor at the Nigerian High Commissioner. I was Assistant Director of Operation in the Defense Headquarters. And I've also had operational appointments at the Nigerian Air Force Headquarters. I was the Director of Operation, and I was the Chief of Training and Operation in the Nigerian Air Force. I was also the Director of Policy, and I've also had the appointment of Chief of Policy and Plans, Nigerian Air Force. I think with all this, I can see that I'm well prepared to handle the job of the Chief of the Air Staff. Well, my vision for the Air Force, or my focus for the Air Force, if elected, stems from the mission of the Nigerian Air Force itself. The mission of the Nigerian Air Force is to ensure the integrity of airspace by gaining and maintaining control of the air while retaining a credible capability to fulfill other air power tasks demanded by national defense and security imperatives. From this mission of the Nigerian Air Force, I have carved out my focus to enhance and sustain critical air power capability required for joint force employment in pursuit of national security imperatives. And I have the key drivers for this vision. I've been focusing on doctrinal development and application of air power in joint military operation. I'll pursue purposeful training and human capacity development. I will also ensure that we can sustain platforms and equipment serviceability through innovative maintenance method and logistic support system. Of course, we are going to foster a disciplined workforce essential for combat readiness, and also boost our morale for improving personal welfare. The chairman, sir, and the distinguished honorable members of this house, these are my CV and mission. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I see that.
Well, that's the last person among the people that are about to be screened. I just addressed the gathering. the house, the direction at which the house will go, I don't know. Let's watch. This is GTV Africa live from National Assembly. Show you. Where the chairman of the committee has just declared section close. You're among you. Where the section has just been declared closed, the direction at which the activities will go, we get to know, but how the events will go, we get to know. You are on live to GTV Africa, live from National Assembly, where the screening of the members is going on, where the screening of the service chiefs is going on. And we have belief that everything that goes on here will let you know. Even the event is going to be at a closed door, but we assure you that we'll come back live after the screening exercise. The transmission will go off depending the time that everything will be settled, because the screening is going to be done internally without the press. And after, we have access to information and other things that may be available to us. But certainly, we are going to be off. We are going to be offline for the time that the internal or the screening will be done. One-on-one for the service chiefs, and after the one-on-one interview that will be happen to them, then we'll be coming back to life. And GTV Africa is our promise, is our art, that we are going to let you into everything that is open. Anything that is open to the press, we'll be giving it to you live from National Assembly here. Our assurance is that everything that is meant to be open will be transmitted to you openly and live to you from this place. We are GTV Africa, live from National Assembly. You know that we are there for you. We are there. It is because of you that we are operating. Every other thing will still come back to you live. Thank you for being there. I am Gbemiga Olamikan, and with me I have Lekan. Lekan is on the camera. Toby is on the camera, and you are sure that details will be given to you live from here. I have somebody here that I will want you to just meet on time, within short time, sir. I want you to just tell us, what are we expecting from this point? Can you introduce yourself so that people will know who you are?
Well, this is you are actually ambushing me.
Yeah, yes.
Appropriately, it's supposed to be the DDI
that's supposed to say something. Yes.
We've just done the open session, yeah, and we are going for the closed session right now.
Okay.
Where the members will have the opportunity to engage with the service chiefs individually.
It's all right.
Thank you.
Can you introduce yourself? Because
Commodore Suleiman Dahun, MNI Navy spokesman.
It's all right.
Thank you.
Where you've heard from him. This is Gbemiga Olamikan. The main man is going out. If I have opportunity, I would like to quickly talk to the Lansing officer. The Lansing officer to just tell us what is expected. Sir, yes, one
I'm
second.
I'm coming back.
It's all right. Well, before we go offline, I'm trying to see what we can get from any of them. But if we cannot, I assure you, after we'll come back to you. We are going offline for a few minutes, and later we'll come back live. Thank you. I'm Gbemiga Olamikan. Yes. Well, thank you for your time.